How to fix IPVanish slow speeds. Testing your speed the right way, in order to get a good idea of exactly what is going on with your internet speed, it is critical that you get reliable information about your speeds while you are connected and on the VPN, as well as getting reliable speed information when you are disconnected and off the VPN. Simply going to a speed test site and running one or two quick speed tests is not enough information and will not yield reliable results, more on why below. The main reason running one or two of these quick speed tests is not reliable is because the speed test server you are testing our VPN server against would actually have to be capable of reaching the full bandwidth or the download and upload speeds available from your internet connection and the VPN server to yield reliable results. Quite often, however, the speed test server does not max out the available bandwidth because of many factors, including but not limited to, transit conditions between it and the speed testing server. As such, relying too heavily on just one or two speed tests can lead to incorrect assumptions and conclusions about the overall speed and performance of your connection to our VPN. Although you may experience some speed loss while on the VPN, your VPN connection may be running faster than it appears. What impacts speed? To answer what impacts speed, we need to first explain what is meant by the word transit. For you, the end user, transit is the path data takes to get from one point to another. For the purposes of this article, transit is the entire path that your data has to travel. Transit can be thought of in the following way. Imagine a car that has to travel from your home to your work. There are multiple streets and in some cases a highway that might have to be taken to get to the destination. The same can be said for your data. It has to pass through multiple networks of varying size and capacity in order to get to the destination. To take the analogy a bit further, some of these streets or networks only have a limited number of lanes, which means that only so much traffic can pass through at once. Additionally, there are always speed limits. Unlike a car, you don't have the option to hit the gas and ignore the speed limit. Your internet service provider promises up to a specific speed limit or bandwidth on their network. The speed tests that they provide will typically be done within their network, meaning that they likely represent the best and the absolute maximum speed of what you can send/receive at your home, but it does not mean that you are guaranteed that maximum upload and download rate outside of your ISP's network. Consider it to be like owning and test driving a race car. You can take it to the track and put the pedal to the metal, but you can't exactly do that in the middle of town, either because there's not enough room or there is too much traffic in front of you to reach full speed. The same can be said for the majority of the internet. When you connect to a VPN, your upload and download speeds will almost always be slower. Why? The connection is likely to be slower because you are making your data go through an extra path or paths. Think of this as taking the scenic route. Taking the scenic route is how you are able to be seen as originating from a different location as opposed to your actual location. On the other hand, the VPN connection could, in some rare cases, be faster because you might be taking a detour around a slower path or route of your trip. This is like taking side streets to avoid a traffic jam on the freeway. Additionally, a VPN typically adds encryption so that the people who can see your internet traffic don't know what data is actually in it. Think of this like getting a new paint job and tinted windows on your car every time you go out for a ride. People looking at you know what it is, but they don't know who it is or what else might be inside. What are the basic steps for getting better speeds? While still using your car as an analogy, think about it like this: what would be the quickest way step by step to go about getting food if you have none in the house, like ice cream? Steps include: 1. Use the fastest car possible. 2. Travel via the least congested street possible. 3. Go to a grocery store, location, that is as close to you as possible. 4. Choose a location that you can check out of quickly. The same conditions can be applied to your internet speed as well. 1. Have a fast ISP subscription in megabits per SEC or MBPs. 2. Visit your website/service via an unrestricted path, which you usually can't choose. 1. Barring not being able to choose the path your data takes, you can and should choose a VPN server that is: 1. Quick and responsive, has a low ping in milliseconds or MS. 2. Least congested, has a low load in capacity percent, a lower percentage is better. 2. Visiting a website/service located in another country or far from you is going to take longer to load than one that is located in your own country or city. Again, you typically can't change this, so. 1. Barring that, choose a VPN server as close to you as possible. 3. A website or service that has limited capacity or intentionally limits how fast you can access or transfer the content will always be slower than one without those limits, or one whose limits aren't as severe. With these things in mind, it is easy to understand how data travels on the internet and to realize some of the inherent flaws. Your data isn't always going to the same place, nor is it always going to go along the same route, and even if it did, that route is often shared by others, which ultimately means that it will not always be as fast. Therefore, changes in any of the above items will cause the speed results to change. For these reasons, running just one or two speed tests will not provide accurate or trustworthy results. If you think you are experiencing slow speeds, first you need to know exactly what your best speed should be, and to know what your best speed should be, you need reliable speed test results. To reliably test your speed, you need to know two things: how fast your internet connection will allow you to go, this is determined by the subscription plan from your ISP, and how to perform a reliable speed test. See the instructions on how to go about answering these questions, below. What is your ISP subscription? Your ISP subscription refers to the speed of your internet connection in upload and download speeds that you are promised by your internet provider. Example, my ISP subscription is up to 100 Mbps down, 3 Mbps up. We now know that no matter what we do, we cannot get better results than this. How do you perform a reliable speed test? You can use almost any speed test site to run a speed test, but you do have to run multiple tests to be confident that the results are reliable. To get started, have a look at our How to Run a Reliable Speed Test article.